Did you know that your food choices each day affect your health, how you feel today, tomorrow, and in the future? Good nutrition is an important part of leading a healthy lifestyle. Combined with physical activity, your diet can help you reach and maintain a healthy weight, reduce your risk of chronic diseases, and promote your overall health. That easy? You bet. Living day-to-day life can be as easy as well as complicated. Today, everyone talks about being on a diet. What does it even mean to be on a diet?
The first thing is that you are what you eat. What you eat determines a whole lot about you, even your body composition and what you are able to do. And so that cliche goes on. Now, food is important for three main things. Number one, provision of energy. The energy to do all that you are able to do is as a result of the food you eat. The second thing is that food is important for growth of the child and also for the repair of the body, the tissues of even the old, the adults. So that's the second thing. And the third thing is that the food also helps, is also important for the proper functioning of the body.
Knowing what to eat is not exactly the same as eating right. To examine what people eat and what informs what they eat, we spoke to Lagosians, and of course, let's go listen to what they said.
Somebody like me, why I dey chop wetin I like to chop? Because na wetin my body wants. If I wake up in the morning, my body say today na ogi. You no go fit shift am despite the money either I no get. Even at 50 naira dey my pocket, I must make sure say I eat ogi. Because if I no give my body system wetin my body want, the whole of that day I no go fit satisfy.
We don't just eat akpu just like that. We eat more of vegetable, which is also good for our health. You understand? We grow fruits and we eat it with fruits. We eat a lot of fruits in my place. We have banana, we have orange, and all these things we just pluck straight from the tree and eat it. And we know that it is good for our health. That's why we eat it a lot. So even if we eat carbohydrates a lot, we also use fruits to dilute it.
It is also interesting to know that eating right means a different thing to different people. And of course, to young adults, it is a very different kettle of fish. Some students of higher institutions of learning share with us their realities.
When I wake up in school, I just find something to prepare to eat. Maybe probably because I'm having lectures that morning, I will just find something light to eat, like maybe drink tea or eat rice or something light that won't disturb me when I'm going out. A lot of times I just have to take snacks, so I won't, you know, probably eat or something.
It affects students too, you know, the fact that they don't eat balanced, you know, students don't eat fruits, and students don't, you know, eat as at when do the rationing of the food is very irregular. So I think it does affect. Every day students have to go to classes, and mostly how my school was set up, there were classes always in the morning. So basically we didn't used to eat before going to school, right? So we had some sort of butcheries in our department. So by say like noon, 11, 12, 1, then we have some sort of first meal of the day most of the time. That's what most people do. And they have snacks, you know, meat pies, donuts and the rest.
Yes, junk foods. What constitutes junk foods? These are pre-prepared or packaged food that have low nutritional value. They include salted snack, gum, candy sweet, fried fast food, and sugary carbonated beverages.
Most people think to eat healthy, you must be rich. But that has its own ugly side. Now, the food you eat should contain carbohydrates in adequate proportion. That's why we do not talk about balanced diet any longer. We talk about adequate diet. Your carbohydrates in proportion, and this also relates to age, then physical activity. So all of these put together, because the energy you take in is also what you use for, you know, you expend on your, you know, your activity. So if what you take is more than what you give, then it's thought of as fat. If what you take is less than what you give, then there's a lot of emaciation, because you lose a lot of weight. You know, so there must be a balance.
At this juncture, being clear on what the importance of food to the human body is, what are market vendors and cooked food vendors saying about sales, cost of items, quality of food, as well as patronage?
Unlike before, things was actually way cheaper than this, but now, because after the lockdown and everything, things have added money. Well, again, is one thing that we are battling with for transportation of goods coming down here from where we buy. So most things now have added money, and some people now, they haven't reducing what they sell, unlike before. Fish that we buy for 200, 150, now it has added money to like 300. When we bring it there, we are not able to sell it. People are complaining. And the whole thing has really affected us.
It's too costly than the one that we are buying before. But what we even look that is, we think that maybe it's because of the season where it's coming that time. It's because of that meat cost that time. But when the season even go, the meat even go up more than before.
People, they buy meat like this.
They are buying it too, because much of people where they are using it to make our own business, they must to buy it.
Okra, before, how many they buy one basket of okra? Quarter 2,000. Now they buy one waffle basket now. 8,000, 9,000. You know they're like that before. Ask anybody. What of this dawa dawa? How much did they buy dawa dawa before? Quarter 500. Dawa dawa now 1,400, 1,500. Well, you know they like that before. Everything just fall. As they open up, before they cut and put up for this nylon, I must wash it. Are you hearing me? So before they cut up, I must put up for this nylon. All those people where you know get fresh, where then they take and cut up for yourself. See the one where I put on my front self. No, they need. As they see me so uncle. Now okra, you good for body. You go use dawa dawa, put up from iru, dawa dawa. Go put only dawa dawa. Dawa dawa na iru. You know as I dey talk. So we are putting iru, dawa dawa, water leaf, green yo, fish yo, ogiri yo, urokro, ice one yo, mama yo.
Some people eat more pepper than tomatoes. Why some want more tomatoes than pepper? And it depends on how you want it to look like. Some people want it in a reddish and thick. It's the same normal price. It has not changed. Just that way people are seeing money now. It's not the way they normally get money then. That is just it. Even with that we are selling, the way people buy, it's not as the way they were buying, they are buying them. We have store. So that place is very secure.
Eating out, whether at parties, bookers, or even cafeterias, as well as your very sophisticated restaurants, have always been critiqued for serving people with salty food, or at best, fatty food. Fat consumption, can we say a thing about it? How bad is it? So often, you hear people say they are cutting back on their fat, or they're avoiding fat altogether. What does this mean?
Like the time where I was sick, where I go to hospital, the doctor told me that my weight is 95. Let me lose some food. I will eat. Make sure some groundnut oil, all these things. Went to supermarket for a rekbo, buy it. But later, no money. I use what I had used before. So maybe all those ones. The fat from family. Because my papa is fat. All of us now soon. So if from the family, nobody say because of food, food make a come fat or drop all these things.
And because we know it is impossible for you not to eat out, looking at the lifestyle of Lagosians, whether you're a 9-5er, whether you're a business person or a hustler, we know that you must eat out. Let's look at what is responsible for what people eat when they go out.
Okay, the kind of foods I like. I like to eat a lot of fruits. I love to eat a lot of protein. And I like eating healthy, actually.
I do all I can to have a balanced diet, you know, having a way of balancing it. I do a lot of protein and carbohydrate because to do my work in a day, I need a lot of energy to think and think things through. They also need, I need protein to also balance everything. Then water is very necessary.
I'm a foodie. I actually love eating. Basically, why I eat, it's because I'm a business strategist. I do a lot of thinking, so I get hungry fast. And I'm also into fitness, so I exercise a lot. And also it drains most of my energy, and I have to take carbs and re-energize. Yeah, actually, I pay attention to my diet. I try to take protein and also vitamins. I try to take fruits as often as I can.
Eating right means cutting back on unhealthy foods in your diet, eating adequate diet, which is a proportional representation of the classes of food in your diet, and if I may add, eating smaller portions of meals. The following benefits are associated with eating right. Weight loss. Weight loss? Don't freak out. Some people do need the loss of weight. That's right. Reduced cancer risk. Heart and stroke prevention, stronger bones and teeth, better mood, better night's sleep. Haven't you heard? We are what we eat. Some have even added that we are what we eat. Now that you know the benefit of eating right, go get your life back.